common themes or common images that would help propagate the word more. After the workshop, we had 19 artists and we realized 56 artworks. So we had an exhibition in Accra. And during the workshop, members of the public also came around to see these works. So we had the opportunity to speak to them about the theme and all. So we had the exhibition in Accra. And then, in order not for it, since the national campaign, we needed to take it around the country. We started with four other regions apart from Accra. So we went to Kumasi, we went to Cape Coast, we went to Takoradi, and then went to Tamale. Since we're out to speak against stigmatization of people living with HIV, it would be good that we don't only say it with our mouths, but we do it in action. So we decided that part of the proceeds from the artworks would go to the network of people living with HIV. Okay, so 50% of all sales of these artworks went to the network of people living with HIV. And we managed to donate an amount of 14,500,000 to this network. And we intend to do more.
So, but what I know is that stigma, the workshop we just did, Ashimis, it's not for, it's for individual now. After the workshops, after the lectures and the exhibition and everywhere artwork we create, it's for us to go to our community. That is what I always say. It's not you go to the TV and talk, that is matter. The purpose why they did it is because each of us are living in different community. You start from your own room to allow people to come out boldly and go and test.
So I think that, you know, if art can be used to promote the cause of anti-stigma, but also for the artists to really, really interiorize that process themselves, then, you know, then they're collaborative projects that make a lot of sense. Because it's very easy in societies where there is a lot of need, or where need is kind of like the major perception of what reality is, for art to just be co-opted. And I also say there has to be a place for artists just to be artists, I mean, just to do their work, and that is worthy of support as well.
When I met Virginia Ryan and Prof Nkrumah, I decided to be, well, to give my small support to FCA. Sometimes it's some of my colleagues are asking us, why are you doing that? Well, what about it? But it could be much better to be to deal with water, sanitation, health, education. Of course, we do that. But I think art is so much important in a society like Ghana, because things are moving so quickly. They need a kind of identification process, you know. They need to show where they are, where they're going, where they come from. So that's from heritage to creation. That's something to do with that, you know. And I think it's very important. It's a kind of democracy, democratic process, but to give our backing to this kind of activities. And we can have a social action. For example, probably you heard what happened at the roundabout just not so far from here, when they cut 13 trees, very old trees.
Some people had grown up with like these trees, you know, they know these trees, this environment. And with a twinkle of an eye, they all like almost butchered, you know. The ironic part of it is that the Ghana 50 Secretariat was preaching green in Ghana.
So we decided with Prof Nkrumah and Virginia to organize funerals, traditional funerals, to this place with the young artists of FCA, just to explain through paintings and through music and through different kind of cultural activities that trees are so much important, not only for the beauty of the city, but also for itself, because neems, that's the name of the trees, are pretty good against malaria. And also because of we need shade.
Just by doing this, drew a lot of people to the grounds, which brought a lot of discussion amongst citizens, and the media also picked it up, which was good.
So that's the kind of, yes, action that we have to improve the situation and to go ahead with development issues. And so that art has something to do with good governance, but also of something to do to help people to be conscious, to be aware of what's going on.
And we call it saving at grassroots.
Ghana in Africa, the government helps support art only to a limited extent. They pay the lecturers and run the art colleges in the education, so they feel that is enough.
Whenever you talk about culture and art with high-ranking people from the government, they always think about Kente, Ashanti tradition, heritage, you know. It's okay. Of course, it's very important, gold and all this stuff, but it's difficult to move from that to creation. That's why it's very important, the work that they're doing at the FCA, because they try to show their own works, not only to the customers who can buy artworks, but also to the population.
The local people, the ordinary people themselves, are art on their own. See, the way they do their things, their language, their hairstyle, their clothing, their food, their music. So they don't feel that they lack aesthetic development. So what we are going to do is broadening, we're making available other possibilities to raise the level of consciousness, African and European art in general, because it's very important. You must grow on ideas and influences and new things that are happening. Otherwise, if you don't grow and grow, you suffer what they call future shock. You know, you wake up and something, the whole world is gone.
Over the past few years, there has been a dramatic increase in the interest in the visual arts by Ghanaians. In the first place, we have a growing middle class now in Ghana who are progressively expressing interest in art. On the other hand, we also have a number of Ghanaians, Ghanaian academics and other people living and working in Europe and the United States have been returning and settling in Ghana. And this group of people are also showing an appreciable interest in the visual arts. Two or three Ghanaian artists have already managed to put Ghana on the world map. We have people like Kofi Setoji, Wiz Kudowo, who won the 2000 edition of the Osaka Triennale, and we have the Professor George Hughes, who's a lecturer in the US. We have Uso Ankuma, who lives in Düsseldorf in Germany, and a lot more who have really made us proud. But there is a problem. Our young artists really need support. And this support will come in the form of sponsorship from corporate Ghana or individuals or the government. Indeed, as of now, there's very little support from government, very little support from corporate Ghana, and very, very little support from individuals. Diplomats and other expatriates living in Ghana have been so helpful. And indeed, if Ghanaians could emulate this kind gesture by expatriates and diplomats living in Ghana, the visual art scene in Ghana will really grow, and we can really put Ghana on the world map of art.
Imagine if there was a really, really good contemporary or modern and contemporary art museum, national art museum here. I mean, what that would do in terms of bringing in the right sort of attention, you know, because we don't always want to hear just the tragedy of Africa. We should also be rejoicing in the very many positive aspects and the talent and nurturing that talent. And the more you nurture talent, the more talent there is. Africa, oh say yeah. Africa, oh say yeah, yeah. Africa, yeah. Africa, yeah. Edikampu, oh say yeah.